Hello, my dear class 9 children. Let us learn today a theorem which helps us to calculate the length of one side of a right angle triangle when the lengths of its other two sides are known. And that theorem is known by the name Pythagoras theorem. So today's topic for us is Pythagoras theorem. In the examination, two types of questions are asked. Remember, two types of questions are asked. One is numerical based, means where we do calculation. Second is proof based. So remember, there will be two types of questions from this chapter in the examination. First one, numerical based, means to calculate one of the side's length. And second, proof based questions. So let us learn what the Pythagoras theorem says. This theorem says that in a right angle triangle, I hope you all are knowing, a triangle is said to be right angle triangle if one of its angle is 90 degree. So this triangle is right angle triangle. This side is the longest side of the right angle triangle and is called hypotenuse. So the Pythagoras theorem says in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of remaining two sides. Let us name this right angle triangle as A, B, C. Square of the hypotenuse, I mean AC square, is equal to the sum of the squares of the BC and AB. So BC square plus AB square. Let us understand its converse statement. Converse of Pythagoras theorem. So we can use this statement conversely to see whether a triangle is right angled or not when the lengths of its all three sides are known. I mean, if the lengths of the three sides of a triangle are known to us and we are asked, find whether the triangle formed by these three sides is right angled or not. So we will be using the Pythagoras theorem conversely. So let us understand what the Pythagoras theorem statement conversely is. In a triangle, if the square of its longest side is equal to the sum of the squares of its remaining two sides then the triangle is right angled and longest side is the hypotenuse. The angle opposite to longest side is right angle, 90 degree. Let us understand it with an example. ABC, in which AB is 6 cm long, AC is 8 cm long, and BC is 10 cm long. You can see BC is the longest side of this triangle. So let us see whether triangle ABC is right angled or not. So for that, we will be getting the square of BC. Which is equal to 100. If the square of BC is equal to the sum of the squares of AB and AC, then we will say that the triangle is right angled. And AB square plus AC square. So this becomes 6 square plus 8 square. 36 plus 64. When we add, we get 100. So what we observe? We observe that BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square. So we will be writing, since BC square is same as AB square plus AC square. Therefore, triangle ABC is right angle and then this BC will be hypotenuse. BC will be hypotenuse, and the angle opposite to this BC, which is angle A, will be right angle 90 degree. Let us use these theorems to solve the questions of exercise 10A from this book, S. Chan's publication book, class 9th, ICSC board students. You can watch the video. To get more videos, you can subscribe my channel. So now I am going to solve the questions of exercise 10A. Let's solve. Question number 1. As I told you, we will be asked two types of questions. One, calculation based, in which we will be calculating the length of one side of a right angle triangle. Another, proof based. So in this exercise 10A, all the questions are calculation based questions. Means we will be calculating the length of a side of a right angle triangle, or we will be finding out whether the triangle is right angled or not. So 10A, question number 1. In this question, the triangle is right angle. One more thing I would like to tell you, my dear students. Let us learn how do we notify the length of the sides of a triangle. If we have a right angle triangle as A, B, C. So you can see this capital letter A shows the vertex A, this B shows vertex B, and this C vertex C. So the length of AC, which is opposite to angle B, is shown by a small letter B. So this small letter B shows the length of AC opposite to angle B. Similarly, length of BC, which is opposite to angle A, will be shown by a small letter A. So the side opposite to vertex C, angle C, is AB. Its length should be shown by a small letter C. So a small c is the length of AB, a small b is the length of AC. This AC is the side opposite to angle B, and a small c is opposite to C. A small a is the length of BC opposite to angle A. So in this question, we are provided C is the length of hypotenuse, as I have mentioned here B, so I need to correct it. Small c is the length of hypotenuse. So this side will be AB, and this vertex will be right angle. So it's quite obvious this will be small a and this will be small b. So in first part we have a equals to 6, b equals to 8. So third is c, which we have to find. So we will be using Pythagoras theorem, which says that in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse, I mean c square, is equal to the sum of the squares of the remaining two sides, a square plus b square. So let us write this statement and do the calculation to find the length of hypotenuse AB. Let's do. So c square is equal to b square plus a square. Substitute the values. A is 6, b is 8. Squaring, we get 64. Unsquaring this, we get 36. Let us add, we get 100. So c square is 100. Therefore, taking the square root, when we take the square root of both the sides, this becomes c and this becomes 10. Actually, we get here plus minus 10. But since this c is the length and we don't measure the length with negative value, so that's why we mention here for the positive value, positive answer, which is 10. Third part of the same question. In this third part, c is 13, b is 5. So a we need to calculate. So by Pythagoras theorem in triangle ABC, c square is equal to b square plus a square. Substitute the values. C is 13. So 13 square is equal to 5 square plus a square. So what shall we be doing? We need to shift this 5 square this side to get the value of a square. So a square is equal to 169 minus 25. Do the subtraction, you will get 144 equals to a square. Do the square rooting. 144 under root a square, you will get here 12. This becomes a, therefore the value of a is 12. Now, question number 2. In this question, we have a rectangle. means a quadrilateral in which opposite sides are equal and each angle is 90 degree. A rectangular field 30 meter by 40 meter. Opposite sides are equal and each angle is 90 degree. What distance is saved by walking diagonally across the field? Means we have to find the distance what we can save by moving diagonally to reach the point C from A. I mean, when we move from A to C along the sides of the rectangle this way, we know that the distance what we have to cover will be 70. So the question asked, instead of walking along the sides to reach from A to C, when we move diagonally, how much distance do we save? I repeat, to reach from A to C, how much distance do we save by moving along diagonal instead of moving along its sides? So let us calculate these two distances. First, let us move along the sides. So AB plus BC. We are going to reach the point C this way. So distance, in first case, the distance covered will be 30 plus 40, 70 meter. Let us calculate AC. When we move diagonally, this AC, let us calculate. Diagonal AC. So to calculate diagonal AC, we will be using Pythagoras theorem. Since I have written here AC, so this side you need to write square root. So AC is equal to under root AB square plus BC square. 30 square plus 40 square. I hope everybody knows that 30 square is 900. Forty square is 1600. When we add, we will get 2500. Take the square root, you will get 50 meter. So when we move diagonally, we get that this distance is 50 meter. And when we move along the sides, we see that the distance covered is 70 meter. So by moving along the diagonal, across the diagonal, you see we cover less distance. So how much distance do we save? Therefore, saving of distance So we save the distance by 70 minus 50. Meter. Next question number 3. In this question number 3, exercise 10A, we need to have the idea of east, west, north and south. Let us have it. You might have studied this in geography. You might be knowing how do we show the east, west, north and south. East, west, north and south. Okay, so due north, due east, due south, due west. So between due north and due east, there is an angle of 90 degrees. Similarly, you can see due east, due south, 90 degrees. The angle between west and south, 90 degrees. So what does the question say? This question says that Hamayan travels 7 kilometer due north. So moving in north direction means this way. So let us move to the north 7 kilometer. This is the starting point. You can write here as starting point. Then the man goes 3 kilometer due east. So from this position, from this place, the man moves due east. You can see due east. 3 kilometer due east. Okay? Angle will be 90. North, then east, 3 kilometer due east, and then 3 kilometer due south. So from this point he moves to the direction of south, means comes down 4 kilometer. So angle between due east and due south is 90 degree, as I explained you, east and south 90 degree. So 7 kilometer, 3 kilometer, 4 kilometer. Let this be the end point. Initial point, starting point, end point of the movement of that man. The question is, how far is he from his starting point? So this is the starting point, that is ending point. We have to calculate the distance between starting point and ending point. This distance we need to calculate. So for that, we will draw a perpendicular from E to this line A, and then name it as A, B, E, C. Drop the perpendicular from E to AS. When you do so, you will get A, B, E, C as rectangle. A, B, E, C will be a rectangle. You just see every angle is 90. 90, 90, 90, this will also be 90, because sum of the four angles of a quadrilateral is 360. So 90, 90, 90, 270, this will also be 90, So if all the four angles of a quadrilateral is 90, the quadrilateral is rectangle. So you can say ABEC as rectangle. And if it is rectangle, then AB equals to CE equals to So this CE is 3 kilometer. BE equals to AC equals to 4 kilometer. Hence, this CS equals to 7 minus this 4, 3 kilometer. This is 7, this is 4, so this CS will be AS minus AC, 3 kilometer. So to calculate the length, one careless mistake I have made, this distance is also 3 kilometer. So this AC will also be 3, not 4. So CS will be 7 minus 3, 4 kilometer. This will be 4 kilometer. Now we wanted to calculate SE. SE is the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. So right in right angled triangle CSE SE equals to under root CS square plus CE square.